Gentleman from the Senate reserves balance of his time. Gentleman from Washington.
Mr. Speaker, I yield 2 minutes to the gentlelady from California, Ms. Lee.
Gentleman from California is recognized for 2 minutes.
Thank you very much. Thank you, Mr. Speaker. And let me thank the gentleman for yielding and for his steady and undying support for people who really have had not, who have had a very tough time and had not had any opportunities for many years now. Thank you, Mr. McDermott, for your leadership. You know, we too are saying, and I'm listening to the debate here about jobs, we're saying where are the jobs? And from what I remember, Mr. Speaker, there were very few Republican votes for the many job creation bills which Democrats have passed. So if you're not going to support a real jobs initiative, I can't understand for the life of me why in the world won't you support just the basics for people, just a bit of help for those who have no jobs and for those who you won't help get a job. Support for unemployment compensation speaks really to who we are as a country. This is a moral and an ethical issue that those who really care about the least of these should support. People have lost their jobs for a variety of reasons. Primarily, yes, the economic policies of the previous administration. We know many people who have lost their jobs due to not being able to find work in this new economy. People have lost their jobs because their communities have been shut down as a result of the foreclosure crisis. They've lost their homes, they've lost their jobs, they have no health care. I mean, what in the world is going on in our country? I think, you know, until we figure this out, I think some of us really get it in terms of the economic policies and what we need to do. But until we make the case in a way that Republicans get it, the least we could do is just help people pay their rent, and for those who still have mortgages, pay their mortgage. For those who, you know, don't have enough food to basically buy food for their kids, we can't even get the Republicans to support a initiative. My goodness, you know, we have over 40% minority youth, African American and Latino youth, who are unemployed, and these young people need jobs. They need jobs. Not only to develop their work skills and work experience, but they have to help their families put food on the table and pay the rent. So, for goodness sakes, just help these people survive and weather these storms right now, because they need something to get through this. Otherwise, we're going to see a country that we all don't want to see, one that we don't recognize, one that does not care about the common good, and this is about the common good. We all have a duty and responsibility to make sure everyone at least is able to survive through these very terrible times. Thank you, Mr. McDermott.
Gentleman from Washington reserves. Gentleman from Louisiana.
Mr. Speaker.